My dear children, how are you? I hope you are fine. Still we are seeing the chapter fractions. Okay. In today's class, we are going to discuss some more concepts from fractions. First, we are going to see even fractions. Already we have discussed proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fractions. So now we are going to discuss about equivalent fractions. What is meant by equivalent fractions? Fractions have different numerator and denominator but are equal to same value. See dear children, fractions have different numerator and denominator. Fractions have different numerator and denominator but they are equal to same value, but the value of the fractions are equal to same value. Such fractions are said to be equivalent fractions. You can easily understand after I explain it. Okay, see here. How many circles you are seeing? You are seeing three circles. See here, children. In all the three circles, only half of the circle is shaded. See here. In the first circle also only half of the circle shaded. In second circle also half of the circle shaded. In third one also half of the circle shaded. So they are in shaded portion. So all the circles, they have the shaded portion equally. Okay. Hope that all the circles are in same size. Okay. Now I am going to write the fractions for shaded portion. See here. This is the circle and this is divided into two equal parts. So total parts you have to write as the denominator. So there is totally how many equal parts? We have two equal parts. So you have to write the denominator as 2. And for the numerator you have to write the shaded portion. Among the two parts only one part is shaded. So you have to write the shaded portion as 1. So fraction for the shaded portion of this first circle is 1/2. Okay. Now see the children. Now I am going to divide the second circle into 4 equal parts. See here. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are totally how many parts? 4 parts. Among the 4 parts, how many parts are shaded? 1, 2. So 2 parts are shaded. So fraction for this circle is 2/4. This fraction for shaded portion of this circle is 2/4. Okay. See here children. Now I am going to divide this circle into 6 equal parts. See here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Think that the parts are equal. Okay. So totally how many equal parts? 6 equal parts. Among the 6 equal parts, how many parts are shaded? 1, 2, 3. So 3 parts are shaded. So fraction for the shaded portion of this circle is 3/6. See here children, the shaded portion in each circle is same. Only half of the circle is shaded. But see the fraction for the each circle. Here we have 1/2. Here we have 2/4. Here we have 3/6. See, the numerators and denominators are different, but their values are equal. Now you read the definition. Fractions have different numerator and denominator. Fractions have different numerator and denominator, but are equal to same value. But they are equal to same value. Such fractions are said to be equivalent fractions. So what are the equivalent fractions here? 1/2, 2/4, 3/6 are equivalent fractions. Since it is an equivalent fraction, we can insert the symbol equal among the fractions. See, 1/2 equal to 2/4 equal to 3/6. Okay. Now listen carefully. How can you find the equivalent fractions of the given number? Okay, see here. First here we have the 1/2. We can find the equivalent fractions of 1/2 by multiplying the numerator and the denominator by the same number. For example, if I multiply the numerator and denominator by 2, 1 2 is 2, 2 2's are 4. Thus, if you multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, you can get the equal fraction of the given fraction. Suppose if you multiply the numerator and denominator by 3, what happened? 1, 3 is 3, 2, 3 are 6. Thus, if you multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, we can get the equal fractions of the given fraction. Okay. Also, if you divide the numerator and the denominator by the same number, suppose if 2 by 4 is the given fraction, let us take. Now I am going to divide the numerator and denominator by the same number, 2 by 2. So 2 by 2, what is the quotient? 1. 4 divided by 2, what is the quotient? 2. Thus, if you divide 2 by 2, you get 1. If you divide the 4 by 2, you get the answer 2. Thus, we get the fraction 1 by 2. Thus, if you multiply the given fraction, that is numerator and denominator by the same number, or if you divide the numerator and denominator by the same number, you can get the equal fraction of the given fraction. Similarly, if you divide this number by, divide this fraction by 3. What happened? 3 divided by 3, 1. 6 divided by 3, again you got the fraction 1 by 2. Thus, read the note, children. Multiplying or dividing, that is by multiplying or dividing both numerator and denominator by same number, we can get equivalent fractions of given fraction. I hope you understand. Once again, read the definition. What is the equivalent fractions? Fractions have different numerator and denominator but are equal to same value. Such fractions are said to be equivalent fractions. Now we are going to do problems based on the concept equivalent fractions. Okay, read the first sum. Find the three equivalent fractions for the following fractions. They are asking us to find the equivalent fractions for given fractions. First sum is 3 by 7. Now we are going to find the equivalent fractions for 3 by 7. In the question itself, they are told we have to find 3 equivalent fractions. Okay, let us find. First step, you have to write the given fraction 3 by 7. Next, you have to write it as 3 into 7 into and instead this part. Now you have to write the number in the numerator and denominator, it should be same. Now I am choosing the number 2. Now I am going to multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number 2. Why we have to multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number? To get the equivalent fraction of the given fraction. So what is your answer? 3 2 is 6, 7 2 is 14. Do you understand? Now once again write the number 3, write the fraction 3 by 7. Again write 3 into 7 into. Now you have to choose the different number from 2. So I am choosing the number 3. So 3 3 is 9, 7 3 is 21. Thus I got the another equivalent fraction of 3 by 7. Next I have to choose another number. You can choose any number, children. You can choose 5, 10, 7, 6, 6, your wish. Okay, you can also choose 100 also. Okay, now I am choosing the number, the consecutive number 4. I am also giving multiplying the denominator by the same number. This is careful, children. You must multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number. Okay, so what is your answer? 3, 4, 7, 12. 7 4 7 28. Thus, the equivalent fractions are. What are the equivalent fractions of 3 by 7? First, you got 6 by 14. So, first of all, you have to write the given fraction. What is the given fraction? 3 by 7. This 3 by 7 is equal to. What is the first equivalent fraction we found? 6 by 14. What is the second one? 9 by 21. What is the third one? 12 by 28. So these are the three equal fractions we have found out for the given fraction 3 by 7. Do you understand, children? See the next sum. Solution B, 16 by 21. We have to find three equivalent fractions. So as with the first sum, first step you have to write the given fraction. What is the given fraction? 16 by 21. Next you have to multiply the 16 by 21 by the same number. Here also I am choosing the number 2. So you have to multiply the numerator and denominator by the number 2. to get the equal fraction. So 16 plus 6 to 12, remainder 1, 1 plus 2, 2 plus 1, 32. Similarly, 21 into 2, 42. So comprehensive groups of orders, we have formed the first equal fraction. Next, I am going to multiply the fraction by 3. So you have to multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number. 6 is 18, remainder 1, 1 3 is 3, 3 plus 1, 4. 1 3 is 3, 3 2 is 6. Thus, we have formed the second equal fraction, 48 by 63. Next, I am going to choose the number 5. So instead of 4, I am choosing 5 itself. It's my wish. I can choose any number. You also choose any number children. Okay. Now I am going to multiply this. 6 5 is 30. So remember 3. 1 5 is 5. 5 plus 3 8. So 18. 1 5 is 5. 5 2 is 10. Plus we have found out the 3 equal fractions of the given fraction 16 by 21. So here you have to write the equivalent fractions are. Whatever the, so first you have to write the given fraction 16 by 21, which is equal to 32 by 42, which is equal to 48 by 63, which is equal to 80 by 105. Why here we are using the symbol equal? Because they are equivalent fraction. That's why we are using the symbol equal among the fractions. Okay. That's all about the equivalent fractions. Then what is the equivalent fractions? Fractions have different numerator and denominator, but are equal to the same value. See, here fractions having the different numerator and denominator, but they are equal to the same value. Fractions having a different numerator and denominator, but they are equal to the same value. Such fractions are said to be equivalent fractions. Okay. Next, we are going to see here a very important concept. Another type of fractions, like fractions, are also the unlike fractions. What is meant by like fractions? Fractions with the same denominator are called like fractions. See here children, suppose if you are considering some fractions, if you are observing that all the fractions having the same denominator means, we can call the fractions as like fractions. See here examples, 1 by 9, 2 by 9, 3 by 9, 7 by 9. See the denominators, all are same, that should be a number 9. So we can call the fractions as like fraction. We can also similarly give some other example, 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 5 by 3. See, all the denominators are equal to 3. Okay, we can also write some other example. See, 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 5 by 3. See, all the denominators are same. So we can call this fraction as like fraction. So like fractions means the denominator should be same. Okay. Next we are going to see unlike fractions. What is the unlike fraction? Fractions with different denominators are called unlike fractions. Like fractions means fractions have same denominator. Unlike fractions means fractions have different denominators. See here example 2 by 3, 1 by 7, 11 by 13, 4 by 10. See, all the denominators are different from each other. So we can call these fractions as unlike fractions. I hope you have understand this concept, children. Okay, it's clear, children. Next, children, we are going to see addition and subtraction of like fractions. See here, children. See the first sum. 1 by 4 plus 2 by 4. Observe the denominator, both are same. So you can easily add or subtract the like fractions. If it is unlike fractions, means you should bring the unlike fraction to like fraction and then you can add or subtract. So what is the condition for addition and subtraction of fractions is there should be a like fraction. If they are like fractions, means you can easily add or subtract. Okay, see the first one. 1 by 4 plus 2 by 4. See, both the denominators are same. So, if it is like fractions, means we can add or subtract. So, here they are given add. So, we have to add these two fractions. How can we add these two fractions? Let us see. 1 by 4 plus 2 by 4, which is equal to, in the denominator part, for the 2, 4, you have to write the 4 only one time. Don't add the denominator, you have to add only the numerator. So 1 by 4 plus 2 by 4, which is equal to, you have to draw the bar like this, and then you have to, for 2, 4, you have to write the 4 only content. Now you have to add the numerator 1 plus 2. So 1 plus 2 by 4. What is the value of 1 plus 2? 3 by 4. Thus, we have found out the answer 3 by 4. Thus, 1 by 4 plus 2 by 4, which is equal to 3 by 4. Do you understand, children? Okay. Let's see the second sum. 2 by 19 plus 4 by 19. See, the denominators are same. So, we can add or subtract these fractions. So, now here they given the symbol plus. So you have to add the fraction. So 2 plus 4. You have to add the numerator only. Don't add the denominator. You have to write the denominator only one time. So 19. So 2 plus 4 by 19. What is the value of 2 plus 4? 6. So 6 by 19. Thus we have added the given two fractions. Next see the third sum. 5 by 6 minus 1 by 6. Here they are given the symbol subtraction, that is minus. So you have to subtract these two fractions. So first you have to subtract the numerator 5 minus 1. Denominator you have to write the denominator only one time. So write 6 here. So 5 minus 1 divided by 6. 5 minus 1 by 6. What is the value of 5 minus 1? 4 by 6. So our answer is 4 by 6. Do you understand, children? See the next one. 19 by 7 minus 2, 2 by 7. See the denominator are same. They are like fraction. Thus, but the first one is improper. The second one is mixed fraction. So the mixed fraction should be converted into improper fraction. And then you can subtract these two fractions. How can we do the sum? See, fourth sum. 19 by 7 minus 2, 2 by 7. So first step you have to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction. Write the first fraction as it is 19 by 7 minus. How can you convert this mixed into improper? By multiplying the whole part into denominator and you have to add the numerator by denominator, that is whole part into denominator plus numerator by denominator. Thus we have converted the mixed into improper. By converting this we find the answer. So 19 by 7 minus 2 7 sum 14 plus 2 by 7. So 14 plus 2, what is your answer? 16. So 19 by 7, 14 plus 2, 16 by 7. Thus we got two like fractions with operation subtraction. Now we can subtract these two fractions. Now can you subtract? By subtracting the numerator. So 19 minus 16 divided by 7. You have to write the denominator one time. Don't subtract this denominator. So 19 minus 16, what is your answer? 3. So 3 by 7, thus we have subtracted the given fraction. So 19 by 7 minus 2, 2 by 7 is equal to 3 by 7. Thus we have found the answer. Next is the fifth sum. In the fifth sum, both the fractions are in mixed fraction. Now we are going to add these fractions. How can we add this fraction? First of all, you have to convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction, and then you have to add the two fraction. So what is the result? 9 11 by 23 plus 12 13 by 23. Now we have to convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction, and then you have to add the fraction. Okay, so how can you convert? So multiplying the whole part, this is the whole part with the denominator. 9 into 23 plus, you have to add the numerator, plus 11 by denominator. Do you understand, children? Whole part into denominator plus 11 by 23 plus, here what is the whole part? 12. 12 into denominator plus numerator by 23. Do you understand, children? Okay. The next step you have to multiply it. So 23 into 9. 9 days are 27. Remainder 2. 9 twos are 18 plus 2, 40. So 207. So 207 plus 11 by 23. Do you understand, children? Plus, next you have to multiply these two values. Plus 23 into 12. So 3 plus 6, 4 plus 4, 1 3 is 3, 1 2 is 2. So 6, 7, 2. So 276. 276 plus 13 by 23. Now you have to add these two values. How can you add? See here. 2. First you have to add 7 plus 1, 8. 0 plus 1, 1. So 218 by 23. Similarly, add these two values. 6 plus 3, 9. 7 plus 1, 8. 2. 289 by 23. Thus, we got two like fractions. Now, you can add these two like fractions. How can you add the like fractions? By adding their numerator. So, 218 plus 289 by 23. Now we have to add these two numbers. So 218 by 289. 9 plus 8, 17. Remainder 1, 8 plus 2, 10. Remainder 1. So 507. So 507 by 23. See here, children. Here we have the answer. 507 by 23. Is it children? 503 by 23. This is a mixed improper fraction. So we have to convert this improper fraction into mixed fraction. How can you convert? By dividing the numerator by denominator. Now we are going to convert this to a mixed fraction. Okay. So 23 into 2. 3 to 7, 6. 4, so 2 times 23 into 2, 46. So after subtracting 46 from 50, you get 4. Bring down the 7, so 47. So again, you can use the 2 times. So 2 23 is 46. So subtracting, you get the remainder 1. So how can you convert the improper into mixed fraction? Write the denominator as it is, and remainder became numerator, and quotient became the whole part. So our answer is 22 1 by 23. Thus we have added the different two mixed fraction, and we got the answer 22 1 by 23. Okay, stay children. Next children, we are going to see addition and the subtraction of unlike fraction. See here. First question, 2 by 3 plus 1 by 7. Observe the denominators 3 and 7. They are not here. Same number. So we can, so the fractions which are having the different denominators are said to be unlike fractions. So we can't add or subtract the unlike fractions. We must add and subtract only the like fractions only. So how can you add these unlike fractions? By converting them into like fractions, we can add this. Okay. How can you convert? Let us see. By converting this denominator into a same number, we can easily change this fraction as a like fractions. How can we convert? By finding the LCM of the denominators. You know already how to find the LCM. Now we are going to find the LCM of the denominator. What are the denominators here? 3 and 7. Now we are going to find the LCM of 3 and 7. So 3 comma 7. Since 3 and 7 are prime numbers, we must use the prime number to divide this. So 3 is divided by 3 only. So 3, 1, 3 is 3. Write the 7 as it is. So again 7 is the prime number. So you have to use 7 for divided. So 7, 1 times. Thus we have 2 numbers. So LCM of 3 and 7 is 3 into 7. So our answer is 21. Thus we have found out the LCM 21. In the last chapter also, we have already discussed how to find the LCM of given number, how to find the LCM of given number. okay, you can refer that if there is any doubt in that, okay. So LCM of 3 and 7 is 21. Now we have found out the LCM. So what is the next step? Next step is you have to convert these two fractions into like fraction. How do you convert first? Write the first fraction 2/3. Okay? Write like this as we did in the finding the value of equal fractions. Like that you have to write. See, now listen carefully. What should be multiplied with 3 to get the LCM? Listen my question carefully. What should be multiplied with 3 to get 21? What is the 21? 21 is the LCM. So we have to convert the denominator into LCM value. Here we got the LCM as 21. So what should be multiplied to 3 to get 21? 7. Because 3 sums are 21. So multiply the denominator and numerator with the 7. We understand children. First you have to write the first fraction. After that you have to write 2/3 into like the extra for. Next you have to find. You must observe the denominator. Don't care of the numerator. You just observe the denominator only. Don't observe the numerator. Okay. What should be multiplied with 3 to get the LCM? 7. So multiply the denominator and numerator by 7. This number should be decided on the basis of denominator only, not on the numerator. Okay, listen carefully. Now we have to multiply these two values. So 7 2 are 14. 3 7 are 21. Thus we have converted this 2/3 into 14/21 as a equal fraction. Next 1/7. 1/7. And then write like this. 1 into 7 into extend this part. Now we have to convert this 7 into LCM value. Our LCM is 21. What should be multiplied with 7 to get 21? 3. So multiply the denominator and the numerator by 3. So 1 3 is 3. 7 3 is 21. Thus we have converted 1/7 into 3/21 and 2/3 equal to 14/21. What are they? They are just their equal fractions. Okay. Now we are going to add the sum. Now we have to write the question. 2/3 plus 1/7, which is equal to. Instead of 2/3, you have to substitute this value. What is the equal fractions of 2/3? 4/21. So here you have to write 4/21. For 2/3, here you have to write 4/21. Plus for 1/7, you have to write these values. What is this value? 3/21. For 1/7, we are writing 3/21. For adding 2/3 and 1/7, we are adding their equal fraction. What are their equal fraction? Equal fraction of 2/3 is 4/21. Similarly, equal fraction of 1/7 is 3/21. Now we are going to add this. How can you add the like fraction? You know already, by adding their numerator. So 14 plus 3/21. So what is your answer? 17/21. Thus we have added the given two fraction. Okay. Next see this sum. 1/12 plus 7/9. See the denominators are different. So we have to convert the denominator as same. That is, we have to bring them into same. It means like fraction. For that we have to find the LCM for the given number. What are the denominators? 12 and 9. Now we are going to find the LCM for them. Okay. Since 12 and 9 are divisible by the number 3. So I am using the number 3 since 3 is the prime number. What are the prime numbers? 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, etc. These are called prime numbers. For to find the LCM and HCF, you must use the prime number for the factorization. Okay. So 12 comes in 3 table, how many times? 4 times. 9 comes in 3 table, how many times? 3 times. Listen carefully, children. 4 threes are 12. 3 threes are 9. Here you have to write only this times, not the table, not the answer. Do you understand? So here you have to write 4 threes are 12, 3 threes are 9. So here we are writing 4 and 3. Again, using 3 to divide this 3. Since 4 is not divisible by 3, write the 4 as it is and 3 1 times. Okay? Now we are going to divide the 4 by 2. 2 2s are 4, 1. So 2 again is the 2, 1 plus we have factorized the given number. Now we are going to find the LCM of 12 and 9. What is the LCM of 12 and 9? How can you find by multiplying these values? While you are writing the numbers, you must write in ascending order. That's why I am writing the first 2 and next 2, 3. Okay, so 2 2s are 4, 3 3s are 9. So 4 9s are 36. Thus we have found the LCM as 36. Okay, now we have to bring this 12 to 36 and 9 to 36. How can we convert? Let us see. So first we have to write the first fraction. What is the first fraction? 1 by 12. First we have to write 1 into 12 into. Listen my question carefully. What should be multiplied to 12 to get 36? We see here 2 2s are 4, 4 3 into 3, 4 3s are 12. 12 into 3 you get 36. Listen children, 2 2's are 4, write the 3 as it is and write the 3 here, 4 3's are 12. Now 12 into 3, what is your answer? 3 2's are 6, 1 3 is 6. So if you multiply the 12 by 3, you get the answer 36. So what is the number? 3. So you have to multiply the denominator and the numerator by 3. So why we have multiplied the numerator and denominator by 3? Because our LCM value is 36. So in order to add these two unlike fraction, we have to bring them to like fraction. To bring them into like fraction, we have to convert the denominator into LCM. Here our LCM is 36. So in order to convert the 12 into 36, we have to multiply the 12 by 3. You must multiply the denominator as well as the numerator by the same number. So don't leave the numerator. You must multiply the numerator also. So 1 into 3, 3, 1 3 is 36. Okay. Whatever you are doing with the denominator, you have to do with the numerator also. Okay. Next, write the second fraction, 7 by 9. Write like this, 7 by 9, 7 into 9 into. What should be multiplied with 9 to get the number 36? What should be multiplied with 9 to get the number 36? Yes, 4. So you have to multiply the denominator as well as the numerator by 4. So 7 4s are 28. Thus we have converted this 7 by 9 into 28 by 36. Now we have to add the given two fractions. So write the question. 1 by 12 plus 7 by 9. In order to add these two fractions, because they are in unlike fraction, we have converted them into like fraction to add it. What is the even fraction of 1 by 12? 3 by 36 plus, what is the even fraction of 7 by 9? 28 by 36. Thus, we have the two fractions with the same denominator. It means they are like fractions. Now we can add these two fractions. How can you add these two fractions? By adding their numerator. So 3 plus 28 by 36. So what is the value of 28 plus 3? 31 by 36. Thus we have added the given two fractions. 1 by 12 plus 7 by 9. We got the answer 31 by 36. Are you understand children? Write your classwork neatly and do your homework correctly. Okay, thank you children.